So in this video, we will be learning about the disjoint set data structure. Now, where is this data structure used? This data structure is commonly used in Kruskal's algorithm in detecting a cycle, and again in a lot of competitive programming problems. Now, what is the task of this data structure? You know components in a graph, right? So assume there are multiple components in a graph and I just give you random two nodes and I ask you if they belong to a same component or not. So if you can tell me in a sudden instance that they belong to the same component, right? So that is where this data structure will be used to tell us if a particular node and the other node belong to the same component or the different component. So let's first understand this data structure. So this data structure is going to provide us with two different operations. The first one is the find parent operation, where the second one is the union operation. Now, what is the find parent operation and what is the union parent operation? Let's first understand this data structure in a very broad aspect, and then we will deep dive into it, understanding the implementation. So assume the number of nodes is 7, right? And I'm assuming that all of the nodes belong to a single component. So this one belongs to a single component, this two belongs to a single component, 3 to a single, 4 to a single, 5 to a single, 6 to a single, 7 to a single. And yes, I'm just saying that everyone is its parent itself. Okay, everyone is its parent itself. So if for the first operation, that is find parent, if someone comes up and says find parent of 3, so you're going to return 3. So that's the task of find parent. It's going to give you the parent of a component. Now these guys are single components, right? So we have at the starting 7 different components. Now the step union 1 2, it means to whichever component 1 belongs, to whichever component 2 belongs, just union them. That means combine them into a single component. So what happens is 1 and 2 gets combined into a single component. So after combining, they will look something like this. Now, since they have combined into a single component, I cannot have different parents for a single component. So let's assume we keep the node 1 as the parent itself. So now if someone comes up and says, give me the parent of 2, find parent of, let's say, 2. So the answer returned will be 1, because the parent of 2 is now 1. So that is what the parent data structure means. And the union is very simple. You just combine the two different components. Now let's assume they are saying union of 2, 3. It means the component to which 2 belongs, the component to which 3 belongs, they will be attached. So after combining both these components, they will look something like this. Now since they are having 3 different nodes, you can again make anyone as the parent. Let's make 1 as the parent. That's okay. So that's the union of 2, 3 done. It's very simple. You just combine them. Now whenever they say union of 4, 5, it's again very simple task. You connect 4 and 5. Now who will be the parent? Let's assume 4 as the parent. So let's keep 4 as the parent. Next it's say union 6 of 7. So we just combine 6 and 7. So let's assume 6 as the parent. Okay. So this step is also done. Then the next step, they say combine 5 and 6. So who is the parent of 5? That's 4. Who is the parent of 6? That's 6. So you combine these two components, right, to 1. So after combining, they will look something like this. So since they have combined, we need to make someone as the parent. So let's assume we make the parent as 4. Now if someone is asking you find the parent of 5, that's going to be 4. Find the parent of 6, that's going to be 4. Find the parent of 7, that's going to be 4. So we have two different components and both of them are belonging. Now till this step, if someone comes up and says, does 2 and 7 belong to the same component? If someone is asking till this step, the answer that 2 will be no. And how does this data structure help you to tell that? You simply find the parent of 2 and you can get the parent as 1. You simply find the parent of 7 and you get it as 4. Now, since both the parents are different, you can definitely say that they belong to different components. Let's assume you have something like 5 and 7. Now do they belong to the same component? Again, get the parent of 5, that's 4. Get the parent of 7, that's 4. So I can definitely say that they belong to the same component, right? So it's very simple. The data structure basically finds parent, and for that we have a find parent function, and we're going to implement that right in the next part of the video. So in the last step, it is union of 3, 7. So both of these will get combined and one of all these 7 nodes will become the parent. So that's how the disjoint set operates for find parent and union. Now let's quickly check out how will they be implemented. So the efficient implementation of disjoint set is done by union by rank and path compression. So what we do is we basically make sure that we have a parent array, right? And every node has himself as the parent when we start off. So let's assume that every node has himself as the parent when we start off. So these arrows are basically saying that these nodes are their parent itself. And we also maintain another array, that is the rank array, which is going to store the rank of all these nodes. Now remember, the initial ranks of every one will be 0. So let's maintain a rank array. Once these things are done, let's start doing the union operations. So at first the union operation says union of 1, 2. So remember, in the implementation what you do is just find the parent of 1 and you figure out that the parent of 1 is 1. The parent of 2 is 2. So after this, figure out what is the value of rank. And you can see that both of the rank is 0, 0. So if both of them have rank 0, 0, you can either take this 1 and attach it to 2, or you can take this 2 and get attached to 1. That is completely your choice. So let's do it in this way. I take the 2 and make sure that it is attached to this 1. And now the parent of 2 will be pointing to 1, right? So please make sure you change the parent of 2 to 1. And whenever you are attaching two similar rank guys, because the rank of this is 0, the rank of this is 0. So you need to make sure that to the guy whom you are attaching, so that's 1. So you make sure that the rank is increased by 1, right? So you make sure that the rank is increased by 1. So the node 2 has been attached. So this union operation has been performed. Now in the next step, it is being asked that union of 2 and 3. It's very important that you do not connect 2 and 3. Rather, you figure out who is the parent of 2. And whenever you figure this find parent, you can easily have a while loop which says parent of 2, then it finds 1, and then it finds parent of 1, and it finds that 1 is himself the parent. So you get the parent as 1. After this, you figure out the parent of 3. And you get that the parent of 3 is 3 itself. So you connect 1 and 3. So that means you have to connect 1 and 3. Now again, you're going to compare the rank. And we figure this out that the rank of this 1 as of now is 1. And the rank of this 3 is 0. Now whoever has a smaller rank, right? Whoever has a smaller rank, you just take it and make sure that it is connected to the other one. So 3 had a smaller rank. So you make sure that 3 is connected to 1. Now why do we do that? Now just assume you would have connected this 1 to 3. So the tree would have become something like this, isn't it? Had you connected 1 to 2. So the tree would have got elongated. Next time when you are finding the parent of 2, 2 would have given 1, then 1 would have given 3, and 3 would have been the parent of 2. So you are increasing the depth of the tree. In order, you are increasing the time complexity. So in order to reduce the time complexity, what we are doing is we are making sure that the lesser rank guy goes and gets connected to the higher rank guy. And remember, whenever the ranks are different, there's no need to increase the rank. Keep the rank as it is. Whenever you are attaching two similar rank guys, then only increase the rank by 1. Because whenever you attach two similar rank guys, the height increases by 1. But whenever you attach a smaller guy to a higher rank, the height of the tree will never increase. Thereby, you will never ever increase the rank. So that's the union of 2, 3. So the next step will be union of 4, 5. And if I figure out the parent of 4, that's 4. Figure out the parent of 5, that's 5. And if I figure out the rank, that is 0 and 0. So you can connect anyone to anyone. That's completely your choice. So what I do is I connect this 5 to this 4, and I say that the parent of 5 is now 4. Now whenever the ranks are same, I know the height of the tree has increased. So what I do is I go to 4, because that is the parent now, and I make sure that the rank is getting increased by 1. So this is what union by rank is. You make sure that the lower rank guy gets attached to the higher rank, and if they are similar rank, you increase rank. So that is what union by rank is. Now going forward, I'll also be telling you what is path compression. So union of 4, 5 is done. In the next step, it is union of 6, 7. Now again, if you find out the parent of 6, that is 6, parent of 7, that is 7, And if you figure out the rank, you'll find that both of the ranks are similar. So what you do is you connect 7 to 6 and make sure that 6 is the parent now. And whenever you're connecting this, the rank will increase by 1 because both of them had a rank as 0. So let's increase the rank by 1. Now what is the next step? That's union of 5, 6. So the parent of 5 is 4, right? And the parent of 6 is 6 itself. So who is having the lesser rank? Now what I see is the rank is 1 in both the cases. So both of them are having the same rank. So again, you can connect anyone to anyone. So let's connect this 6 to 4. So when you connect this 6 to 4, what happens is 6 goes and says, now 4 is my parent, right? And 7 is with it. So what you see is you're connecting two similar rank guys. So again, the rank will increase. So the rank increases by 1, that becomes 2. Again, that's very natural. The depth of the tree is 2, that's why the rank becomes 2. So this guy is the larger depth tree now. So the union of 5, 6 is also done. Now in the next step, I have union of 3, 7. So the parent of 3 is definitely 1, right? The parent of 3 is definitely 1. Now the parent of 7, if you find out, the parents of 7 will be 6. The parent of 6 will be 4. So ultimately, you'll figure out that the parent of 7 is 6 and then the parent is 4. So the ultimate root or the parent of the tree is 4. And this is 1, right? So before joining, this is where you do the path compression, right? This is where you do the path compression. So while figuring out the parent of 7, you had to go to 6. You had to go to 4. Now, in the next step, let's assume you are again having a union operation and again there is something like union of something comma 7. Again, you'll be finding the parent like going from 7 to 6 to 4. So, why don't we optimize this? Once you have figured out that the ultimate parent of 7 is 4, why don't you take this parent and make sure that this pointer is pointing to 4 itself? So this is what is known as path compression. So what you have done is, once you figured out that the parent of 7 is 4, you just make sure 7 is pointing to 4. So that the next time, whenever you have to find the parent of 7, you don't need to go to 7, 6, 4. You can directly go from 7 to 4 because this is the path compression that you have simply done. Right, this is a very simple path compression that we are doing. So just assume, just in case, you had something like 4, 6, 7, 8. Let's assume. And you are finding out the parent of 8. 8 would have gone to 7, 7 would have gone to 6, 6 would have gone to 4. But everyone's ultimate parent is 4. So you figured out 8's parent is 4. So what you did is a path compression. Yes, directly saying 8, your parent is 4. So this link goes. 7 also figured out that its parent is 4 in that process. So you did a path compression and you said 7, your parent is 4. So for the next time, whenever someone comes up and says, give me the parent of 8, you can directly get 4 instead of going 8, 7, 6, 4. So that's the path compression that I was talking. I'll show you how to do this in code. It's a very simple task. But this is what is known as path compression. This allows you to minimize the number of movements while finding the find parent of a given node. So currently, once 7 has got its parent as 4, we have a tree like this, right? What is the rank of this one? The rank of this one is 1, and the rank of this 4 is nothing but 2. So I can see this guy is a larger tree and this guy is a smaller tree. Now it's very obvious, if you attach a smaller tree to a larger tree, the depth will not increase. But when you do the opposite, when you attach a larger tree to a smaller tree, the depth is going to increase. So what you do is, you say this one to go and attach with this 4. So 1 comes up and says, I'm going to attach with this guy. So I will have a structure like this when I talk about parents after this union has been performed. Now this is how the structure looks. Talking about the path compression. Again, if someone comes up and says, find parent of 3, what you do is, from 3 you go to 1, you go to 4. So the parent of 3 is actually 4, the ultimate parent. So again, you can do a path compression. Instead of this, you can directly say this is what path compression is. Every time you find a parent, you make sure it's directly pointing to 4. So that from the next time when someone comes and says find parent of 3, you don't again have to go 3, 1, 4. You can directly say it's 4 because that is the ultimate parent. Now since you have understood the disjoint sets implementation, let's talk about the time complexity. The time complexity of both of these operations have been found out to be big O of 4 alpha. Yes. Now this is mathematically proven and it's almost near about a 2 big O of 4, which you can say it's almost a constant time operation if you're using this data structure. So just in case there are m operations, you're actually taking m times, right? You're just taking m times to do the union because every union operation is being done in a constant time. So that's about the time complexity. And the space complexity is very simple. You're using a rank array as well as you'll be using a parent array. So you're using an extra space of big O of n in order to implement this data structure. Now let's quickly deep dive and check out how are we implementing this data structure. Now since the C++ and the Java implementation will be exactly similar, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply write just the functions so that even if you're a C++ user or a Java user, you can understand the union operations, the find parent operations and the initial operations. So let's assume this is the void main, public static void main if you're using Java. And what I do is I initially have a parent array, right? So we can have a parent array. So let's assume I'm declaring everything globally. But in the next videos, I'll be showing you how to use vector and array list when we will be implementing the Kruskal's algorithm. So let's assume you have a parent array, we have a rank array, assuming the max size is 10 to the power 5. So these two will be there. Right at the first, you call something as make set, right? And this will do what? If there are n nodes, right? If there are n nodes, what it will do is it will run something like this and it will make sure that everyone's parent is he himself and the rank of everyone is 0. That's the first step that you will do, right? That's the first step. The next step is to write how to find a parent. That's a very simple step. If you have the node, I can say if the node is equivalent to he himself, that's the ultimate one, because if the node is himself the parent, so that's the ultimate parent. So you can say that's the ultimate parent. And or else what you can say, let's go across and find out the parent, right? So parent of node, you basically go from 6 to 4 to 3 and so on, and you figure out whichever is the ultimate parent that you return. So this is how the find parent will look. But is this path compressed? No, this is not. In order to path compress, we simply write parent of node equal to find parent. So this will path compress it, because just assume you're going from 7 to 6 to something like 7, then you went to 6, then to 4, and then to 3. Just assume you are doing this. And ultimately, the parent was 3. So you return 3. So this 3 is going to be the parent of 4, the parent of 6, and the parent of 7. So you compress it for everyone. That is what you did. You directly stored the parent, whatever it was returned. This is what path compression does. Right? So you have understood the compression technique. Now let's understand the union technique. So if I'm asking union, obviously we will have couple of nodes. One is the node U, while the other one is the node V. What was the first step that we did? We figured out the parent of them, right? So call find parent and figure out the parent of U. Call again find parent and figure out the parent of V. So I figured out both the parents. Now if you remember, if the rank of this guy was smaller than the rank of the other guy, you took U and you attached it to V. So you're saying parent of U will go and attach to V. That is what you did. Or else if the rank of the other guy was smaller, right? If you remember, rank of V was smaller than rank of U. So what you did was you said parent of V will be U. You took V and you said go and attach yourself with U. That's what you did. But what if they're equal? Then you could have done anything. Let's assume I say V will go and attach with you. Let's assume I'm saying V is going at attaching with you. So since they're equal, the level of the tree will increase. And if the level of the tree increases, you're attaching it to you. So the level will only increase if you're attaching two similar guys. If you're attaching two similar guys, then only the level or the height of the tree is going to increase. And this is what the union operation is going to be. Now, if someone gives you M operations, that's a very simple task. You take all the M operations and you just do it like this, right? It's int u, v, and you simply do a union of u, v every time. If someone is asking you if they belong to the same component or not, that's a very simple task. If someone is asking if 2 and 3 belong to the same component or not, please do this. Find a parent of 2 and find parent of 3. If they are unequal, do not use the parent array, because that will never give you the ultimate parent, the final parent. You want the final parent, right? So in that case, you have to use find parent. If both of them's find parent are unequal, they belong to different component, you can just simply say they belong to the different component, or else you can say they belong to the same component, right? So this is how the data structure can easily be implemented. This is the union operation. Again, you're just calling the find parent. So ultimately, this find parent is working in BGO of 4 alpha. Now, this is mathematically proved. If you do not use this parent of node, if you do not use this path compression, then it will be working in logarithmic, right? It will be working in logarithmic. Now, this is a very simple implementation. You can also do this in Java because it's almost similar, right? So guys, this will be it for the video of union by rank and path compression. I hope you have understood the entire concept of disjoint set data structure. So just in case you did, please, please, please make sure you like this video. And if you are new to our channel, do consider subscribing. And with this, I'll be wrapping up this video. Let's meet in the next video. Whenever your heart is broken.